The Lord be with us in spirit and truth, precious heart dwellers. Dear family, I'm asking for your patience with me as I bring something before you that's vitally important for others to understand, and even perhaps for you. Many years ago, I discovered the testimony of a woman who I believe has spoken nothing but the truth. I'm going to share that with you now, because there are those looking in on this channel that desperately need to hear this before it's too late for them. So I ask you to please indulge me as I present this woman's experience, which has been verified by the Lord that it is true. And I ask you to pray. Please pray for those who really need to hear this video.
We began to go high into the sky, and I could see the earth below. And out of the earth came types of tornadoes, or funnels-like. And I asked Jesus, what are these? Jesus said, these are gateways into hell. And I knew within me that these could not be seen with a natural eye, but with the eyes of the Spirit. I remember hearing people say when they died, they went down a dark tunnel. And I knew this was what they were talking about. We began to descend down one of these gateways into hell. Friends, there was a deep darkness all around, and a smell so horrible that it was hard to breathe. All along the sides of this tunnel were forms of all sorts embedded into the walls, and a gray mesh in front of them. They could move out, but would be still attached to the walls were demon powers behind this gray mesh. A horrible smell and terrible screams came from the inside of this tunnel. My friends, if Jesus Christ had not been with me, I would not be here today to share with you this revelation of hell. These evil spirits seemed to be ready to be spewed upon the earth. Evil laughter rang out in screams of death and an odor so horrible that I could hardly breathe. Yes, I had all my senses, and I was in a spirit form. Truly, the Lord thy God has all power of heaven and earth. My friends, this is not pretty what you're going to hear. Screams so sad filled the air as we came near the base of the tunnel. Piercing cries and screams were coming up the dark tunnel to meet us. I could hear cries of all sorts filling the air. I could feel fear, death, and horror all around, and the smell of decaying flesh was everywhere. Never on earth had I felt such evil or known there were such cries of the dead. There seemed to be a force of evil winds and a small suction force ahead of us. Light and dark shadows flashed in the darkness. I also saw large snakes moving up ahead in the muck of the earth. Screams and cries of regret were echoing up through this tunnel. Hell, Jesus said, lies in the center of the earth. Hell is in a bodily form. Where God has a body of believers, hell has a body of unbelievers. Hell was not created for man. It was created for the devil and his angels. Jesus said again, we're about to enter the left leg of hell. Ahead is such sorrow, sadness, and horror. Forms of evil and souls of many are ahead of us, my child. I will grant you strength and protection as we go through hell. Much of the things you're about to see will save many, many people from coming here. This is real. Jesus said, this is your life if you choose it. And Jesus said, fear not, for I shall be with you at all times, for I will never leave you nor forsake you. My word says that in the last days the mysteries of God shall be revealed. And this is a hidden mystery revealed unto the world. We walked on. Hands seemed to reach out at us from the darkness, and I stood very close to Christ. We stopped from the tunnel into the left leg of hell. Jesus was a bright light, brighter than the sun at times, and the form of a man was inside that light. Jesus says, the Father has spoken. Come, we must obey. Jesus said, you have all your senses in hell that you died with. Fear was on every side, and untold danger was everywhere. Each step I took was horrible, and we walked on to the first pit. My brothers and sisters, as far as I could see, miles and miles into the left leg of hell were pits of fire dug into the earth. These pits were about 2.5 feet deep and 3 feet across, and red-hot brimstone was embedded inside these pits. My friend, I pray that the Spirit of God touches your heart as you hear this, and you'll never be the same, and that you'll never forget that there are people in hell today that used to be alive and walking on this earth. Please, I beg you, if you're a sinner, repent. Come unto Jesus and be saved. We walked up to the first pit, and I heard a cry from the center of this pit saying, Jesus, have mercy on my soul. With horror, I recognized it was the voice of a woman. The burning flesh hung by shreds all over her form as she stood there. Here, people, was a lost soul that had died and went to hell. She was a skeleton with a dirty mist inside that was her eternal soul. All over her body hung parts of flesh that was full of decay and dead gray in color. The fire would start at her feet in small flames and go up all over her body. There seemed to be a constant burning of her body. At times, the flames were like embers, and she was reaching out to Jesus. I looked at Jesus, and he had such compassion and sadness in his face. The burning flesh hung by shreds, and her color was a dead gray. There was no hair upon her skull. Where the eyes had been were empty sockets. Yet, my friend, that soul had all its senses that she had died with. Cries and moans of regret came from this soul like you have never heard. Jesus said, my child, you're here with me to let the world know that sin is death and hell is real. I looked at the woman again and I saw worms crawling out of parts of her skeleton form, and the fire did not burn them. And I thought of the word of God where it says that the fire would not burn the worms. Jesus said she knows they are there and she feels them within herself. Oh, God, have mercy, I cried. As the fire reached its peak, the horrible burning would start over again. And I watched in horror. Great cries, deep sobs shook the form of this soul as she cried out, lost, no way out, forever lost in hell. Oh, my Lord Jesus, I screamed, how horrible to be in hell. For as far as my eyes could see were thousands burned in hellfire. Their soul could not float outside the rib cage or above the head or hip area. It seemed to be encaged inside of their skeleton form. But yet they could talk and they could move, and they knew everything going on about them. In Luke, in the Bible, it talks about the rich man and Lazarus, how the rich man could speak out of hell, how he could see out of hell. And yet, my friend, the world goes on, and many are dying and going to hell today. We walked on the path to the next pit. The pathway twisted in and out as far as I could see. Burning hands reached out to Jesus, and souls began to cry out to him for mercy. We came to another pit and stopped. And when they spoke, I knew if it was a man or woman. A man's voice cried, oh my God, have mercy on me. Great wailing sobs came from this man. I'm so sorry, Jesus, forgive me. Take me out of here. I have been in this place of torment for years. I beg you, let me out. Great sobs shook his frame, and he was the same as the woman looked, how sad. I beg of you, he cried, let me out. Again, he cried. Jesus, too, was crying. He looked up and said, my Father, have mercy. And as he did, my friends, the fire seemed to die down some. The man seemed for a few minutes to have flesh on him, and it melted in the fire. His cries were so sad that his whole body shook. Oh, Jesus, have not I suffered enough for my sins? I have been here for 40 years. Jesus said, it is written, the just shall live by faith. All mockers and unbelievers shall have their part in the lake of fire. You would not believe the truth. Many times my people were sent to you to show you the way, but you would not listen. You laughed and refused the gospel. You mocked the Lord and would not repent of your sins. My Father gave you chance after chance to serve him, yet you would not. My life was forgiven for you on the cross, but you would not repent of your sins and live unto God. My blood was shed for your sins, that you might be saved from this horrible place. If only you had listened, said Jesus. Jesus wept. I know, Lord, I know, the man cried. But I repent now, Lord. Jesus said, too late, the judgment has been set. The man cried, O Lord, some of my people are coming here. They also have sinned against you and will not repent. Please, Lord, let me go tell the ones who are yet alive on the earth to repent of their sins and not come to this place of torment. Jesus said, they have my chosen ones, the preachers, the teachers, the elders, and the prophets, the ministers of the gospel to tell them, and many other ways. At this, the man got angry and began to curse, and evil blaspheme words come from him. In horror, I looked at him, and as I did, flames began to rise up to his chest, and dead gray and decaying flesh began to burn and fall off. There was no life or blood in him. Death was all around. I could see the skeleton, like a hand inside a glove, and inside the shell of a man was a soul, and this was a dirty white mist that filled the inside of his skeleton. I screamed, oh my Jesus, how horrible. Jesus said, hell is real and the judgment of God is real. I love them, but this is only the beginning of horrors I have to show you. There is more. Come and follow me. We came to a next pit, and in this pit was a very small frame of a person. And for some reason I knew her age. I knew she was about 80 years old, and I knew it was a woman. I don't know how I knew her age, but I did. She seemed to have a type of skin on her bones, and it was constantly being removed by flames. And somehow I knew that a lake of fire flowed through here at times, for all was burnt and cracked and dry everywhere I looked, except where the pits of fire were. As I watched the fire begin to burn her inside and outside, and I wanted to pull her out of the fire and scream that Jesus would restore her. Oh, God, how horrible, I cried. I don't know if I can go on, for the horrors are beyond belief. These torments existed as far as I could see. Never before had I heard hell preached like this, never before. And I thought within myself, if the world would only know how real hell is, they would never want anyone to come here. Her cries were so sad. She put her bony hands together as if in prayer. And Jesus knew my thoughts. He said, my child, when people are sent here, they have the same feelings and thoughts as when they were on earth. They remember all their families and friends, and all the time they had a chance to serve me but would not. It is always with them. I looked at the old woman again, and this time I noticed that she had only one leg, and there seemed to be holes drilled in her hip bones. My Lord Jesus, I cried, what is this? He said, while on earth, she had cancer and was in much pain. Surgery was done and her leg was removed. She began to blame God and say God did this to her. She began to grow very bitter and angry towards the Lord. My child, she backslid and she would not turn back unto the Lord. And when she died, she came here. The old woman began to cry out to Jesus and she said, my Lord Jesus, please forgive me. If only I had believed while I was on earth. Great sobs, she cried out to Jesus. If only I had believed and repented before it was too late. Oh, my God, help me. I am forever in pain and torment. I cannot die. I cannot rest. Oh, my God, my soul is truly in torment. Jesus said again to her, and he always answered him with his word, you were told to depart from evil, do good, seek peace, and pursue it. You would not forgive others or believe and repent. You had chance after chance. You let bitterness, envy, and strife grow in your heart and would not repent and give it to me nor ask me to take it from you. Sadness was all over Jesus' face as we walked away, leaving the pitiful old soul burning in fire. We came to another pit, and in it, my friends, was a woman as if clawing the sides of this pit. She was bent over clawing. She was in the same state as the others, in a skeleton form, and fire engulfing her. And she seemed frantic to dig her way out of this pit of fire, but she could not. My friend, where her eyes had been were empty sockets, and where her nose was supposed to be was nothing but flames engulfed her. A small fire was burning around her feet and would come up all about her body as she was kneeling and clawing the sides of this pit. We watched as she finally seemed to get to the top of the pit with her feet, and I thought she was going to get out, when a large demon with large wings, which were seen to be broken at the top, shoved her back into the pit. I watched in horror as she fell back into the flames, screaming for mercy. I cried, "Oh, Lord Jesus, why is she here?" "My child, the judgment has been set. God has spoken. Even as a child, I called her to repent and serve me. When she was 16 years old, I manifested myself to her and I said, 'I love you. Give your life unto me and follow me. I will train you and teach you my ways. I've called you for a purpose. Fear not, walk with me. Be gentle, be kind, be forgiving, and understand the will of the Lord.' For years, my child, I called and dealt with her, but she hardened her heart and rejected my sweet spirit. The woman said to Jesus, 'My soul is truly in torment. There is no way out. Lord, I wanted riches, fame, and fortune instead of you, and I got it. I turned my whole life and heart and soul over to the devil, and Lord God, I rejected you. I knew the tenderness of the drawing of your spirit, but Lord Jesus, I rejected you. And this is my end, and this is my torment, day and night. Oh Lord, although you continued to draw me, I thought I still had tomorrow or the next day. I thought I could serve the devil and the world and repent on my deathbed. But oh my God, how wrong I was. One day I was killed and my soul ended up here. Oh, how pitiful was to hear the cries of this woman unto the Lord Jesus. And I thought of how rebellious many of us are. Oh my God, have mercy, I cried. Such deep sorrow filled my soul as we walked on and I walked beside Jesus. From pit to pit we went talking to the souls in hell. Sin and death and corrupt was all around. There are many degrees, many torments, and many chambers in hell, Jesus said. Remember to tell the people of the earth, all of you that hear this tape or read the book on hell, that hell is real. Millions are in hell, and many more are coming. Fire and death are all around. And on the great judgment day, death and hell will be cast into the lake of fire. That will be the second death.